नामश्रेष्ठम अनुमति रूपं तस्याग्रजगुरिपुरीं दोषवाटीं राधाकुण्डं गीवरमहो राधिकामाथवासम् प्राप्तो यस्य प्रथितकृपया श्रीगुरुं तं नतोऽस्मि वंशाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्यैव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो महाबदन्नाय कृष्णप्रेमप्रदायते कृष्णाय कृष्णचैतन्यनाम्ने गौरत्वे गुरवे गुरुन्द्राय राधिकायै तदालये कृष्ण कृष्णभक्ताय तदभक्ताय नमो भक्त्या विहीना अपराधलक्ष्यै क्षिप्त्वाश्च कामादितरङ्गमध्ये कृपामयीं त्वां शरणं प्रपन्ना वृन्दे नमस्ते चरणं यं प्रव्रजन्तमनुपेतमपेतकृत्यं द्वैपायनो विरहकातरया जुहाव पुत्रेति तन्मयतया तर्वोभिनेदु तं सर्वभूतहृदयं मुनिमानतोऽस्मि तवैवास्मि तवैवास्मि न जिमामि त्वया विना इति विज्ञाय राधे तं नयमाम चरणं दिदे I started Srimad Bhagavatam yesterday. Parikshit Maharaj has gone to conquer whole world and he was tired. He just came in the ashram of a very famous rishi. And he saw that he was meditating. His eyes were closed and he was meditating. He thought that he has seen me and now he has closed his eyes, that I am a Vishayi, materialistic person. And he thought that I want water, I'm so thirsty, and he is not giving me water. So I should give him some reward because he is not doing well. Anyone, if comes, you should try to welcome him. Not anything, even by sweet words. Even sweet words he is not giving and not drinking water. So I must reward. And he took a dead serpent and gave him in three rounds. But when he did, at once, he thought that if he is truly meditating God, Supreme Godhead, then I have done so much offense. And by this offense, I will go to hell. My everything will be despoiled. He was walking towards his kingdom, but he was thinking. And in the meantime, the son of that Rishi, you know the name of Rishi?
Samik Rishi.
Son, he was only of 5 years age. Only he was age of 5. He heard that anyone has given serpent in the neck of my father, he at once became so angry. And he took water, though he was naked and only boy of 5, but he was so strong. So he took some water and told, "Oh, now the dogs have been master. We had some dogs to
watch
kitchen room, but dogs himself entered our
kitchen
room and he began to test all these things. So I will punish them. The Kshatriya kings are like dogs. Only to guard Brahmins everything and to serve. But now they are thinking that we are master of whole world. So he has punished my father, so I will punish him." And took water and told, after seven days, the serpent will go and bite him, those who have given this. And he poured the water here. And he came to his father and he went in the lap of his father and began to weep loudly. The father at once woke, "Why you are weeping?" Then he showed that, "Oh, you should see, there is a serpent on your neck. Oh, I'm seeing that you have given cause to that person who has done, he at once knew. He closed his eyes and saw that Parikshit Maharaj. He at once became so worried and told his boy that, "You are not a Brahmin boy. We have no patience. We have no dharija.
Patience.
Or koi?
Tolerance.
No tolerance. Brahmins don't tolerance anymore. But actually, you have been depreciated by Brahmins and Brahmachari. Why he cost? You know that he is very religious person, and if he will die, then whole world will upset. You have not done good thing, you have done wrong." And then he at once sent one of his students, go and at once tell Maharaj Parikshit that after 7 days, 7th day, a serpent will come and you must die. Anyone cannot
save you.
At once running, he went to the king, Parikshit Maharaj. He was going to his kingdom, but he was so worried. I have done wrong. Why I did? And in the meantime, this boy came there and told that our Guru has sent me to tell you that on 7th day a serpent will come, Takshak will come, and he will bite you and you will die. So you can do anything for him. And he returned. Parikshit Maharaj became so happy instead of being worried. "Oh, this is not a cause, but it is the mercy of Krishna himself. I was forgetting him. And I was duly not doing anything for him. Now I will give up everything, my whole world, my whole kingdom, my wife, my children, everything. And I will have to do something for that. I was thinking for so many years that I should give up all these things and to worship Krishna. But I was not doing. This is the same case with us all. But we have no knowledge like this. We are not thinking in his line, but we should try to think. Today or in night, after 2 days, 3 days, 4 days, we must die. But we are always hankering so much for testing these worlds, new marriages, new everything. We know that we will not die. And we will test these material worlds. So we must. Then he at once took off his all royal dresses, his bow and arrows, his mukut,
crown.
And without any management of his kingdom, he returned to Ganges. And he went to Ganges. And there he did sashtang pranam to Ganges and he sat down. I will not main uth karke nahi baithunga. I will not take anything. I will not sleep. I should not take water. Anything. And I must be here. In the meantime, all the rishis from whole world at once knew this fact. There was no communication like today, no
computer
or anything,
telephone,
anything was
email.
Not. No mail, email or anything. But they have more powerful email, more powerful. Then you at once, and about 80,000 rishis, and so many grihastha and all rishis at once assembled there. In a moment, he asked them that if anyone is dying at once, what he should do? And if anyone will die today, tomorrow, day after tomorrow, in 10 years, 100 years, 5,000 years, he will die. He must die. So what is his duty? In the meantime, Narada Rishi, Vyas, Parashar, you know Parashar, the father of Vyas, the guru of Vyas, Narada. Also so many realized saint, Brahmagya, they all were gathered there. In the meantime, Sukhdev was coming. Sukhdev came there. Like a mad person. Naked, quite naked. Some women were giving dust on his body. Some boys were clapping and giving some little stone on him because he was like a mad. But he had nothing cared. When he reached near assembly, all stood up and welcomed Parikshit Maharaj and Narada, Vyas, all being superior also. They welcomed that boy and they kept the same chair. And he folded his hand and asked, anyone who is dying at once, he is on bed of death, what he should do? And those who will die in a day, 2 days, what they should do. Then he began to do Mangalacharanam. Janamadasya jata anvayadi taratasya अभिज्ञो स्वराट तेने ब्रह्मरिदाजयाद कपये मुह्यंत जत सूरज तेजो बार मृदाम जथा विनिमयो जत्र सर्वो अम्रिशा धामनाश्रेन निरस्त कोहकम सत्यम परम धीमहि. दिस इज द फर्स्ट श्लोक. दिस इज द मंगलाचरण. Here it has been told that Sri Suk Ubacha, that Sukdev told. Sri, what is the meaning of Sri Suka? Sri means having so much affluence, good qualities. In all qualities, what is best? Krishna Bhakti is best among all, supreme. So he has that thing. He was detached from worldly things. He was never attached to anyone from his birth. I told about his birth. Nothing was there to be attached for him. Always remembering Krishna pastimes, because he was the disciple of Vyas and son of Vyas. And he has taught, Vyasdev himself taught Srimad Bhagavatam. So he is Sri. Also there is another meaning. Our acharyas have discovered this meaning. Sriya Shuka. Sri means in Sanskrit, these are words. Sri means Sriya. Sriya means of Sriya. Sri. Who is Sri? Lakshmi is Sri. Satyabhama, Rukmini, all are Sri. Sita is Sri. But here, of all Sri, among all Sri, who is supreme? Supreme. Srimati Radhika is. So, means that the Sukh very near and dear of Srimati Radhika. The Sukh was of Srimati Radhika. Krishna has also Sukh. Sukh means parrot. But Srimati has also a very good parrot. She used to keep that parrot on her hand and
Karas.
Stroking. Yes, stroking. Very lovely. Giving some
pomegranate seeds.
Very beautiful, very tasteful, sweet.
Milk and rice.
And sometimes mixing
milk and rice,
so beautiful rice. And he used to give by his own hand, by her own hand. And teaching him that parrot, oh, you should speak Krishna, Krishna. Very lovely. And doing like this. Parrot in the same tone, in same
tune,
he told, as if Srimati Radhika is speaking herself. So Radhika heard that. Krishna, Krishna. She became so happy. He was teaching her so many things. And he was repeating. And thus she was loving. One day she was doing, and by the nature of birds, he flew away from there, her hands. And he flew to Nandagaon. And in Nandagaon he sat on a tree, tamal tree. And Krishna and Madhumangal were playing themselves there. That parrot sat on the branches of that tamal tree and very sweetly she was calling, he was calling, Krishna, Krishna, Krishna. Then Krishna thought, where is Srimati Radhika? Where? He was looking here and there, no Radhika there. At last he saw that, oh, this very beautiful parrot is telling in the same tune, in the same way like Srimati Radhika, as if Srimati Radhika is telling Krishna, Krishna. He became so happy and he called that parrot. But parrot was telling a slok there, very beautiful slok. The meaning of this slok is it. I am telling from the book of Krishna Kavi Karnapur, Vrindavan, Ananda Vrindavan Champu. He is the authority. No? He is so much authority. He is telling that that parrot was lamenting and feeling so much separation for Srimati Radhika, her master, his master. And he was telling very sweetly, weeping like weeping, tears in her, his eyes, that, oh, I had a very beautiful, marvelous, loving master. I was on his hand. She was loving me, giving me
pomegranate seed,
that seed and
rice and meal,
rice or meal, and loving me so affectionately. And she was teaching me to speak Krishna, Krishna. But I'm unfortunate, so unfortunate that I, at once, by the nature of my bird, I flew from there and come here. So I'm so unfortunate. And she was lamenting so much. Krishna became more charmed. Oh, it seems that her master is Srimati Radhika. And he has taught this parrot. So he became more charmed. And he did like this. Oh, come on, come on, come on, in his sweet words. At once he was charmed and came on the shoulder of Krishna. Krishna took in his hand. I want to hear more. Same thing you uttered. And he began to Krishna, Krishna. And that is slow. He also uttered very sweetly, as Srimati Radhika is telling. Then Krishna was so happy. He told that, I will never return this parrot to anyone. Forever I will keep it with me. In the meantime, he saw that two sakhis are coming, Lalita and Vishakha are coming. They went to Krishna and told, Krishna, this parrot is of Srimati Radhika. Radhika cannot leave without this parrot. She may die, and this parrot may be dead. So please return it, and we will give it to Srimati Radhika. She is searching where he has gone. Krishna told that, if it is yours, then you can call, he may go to you, then you can take it. They tried, but he was attached to Krishna's hand that he could not go. As you should call, they told that anyone who will go to you, they will be attracted to you, will not go to you. But if my Sakhi will come, he will come at once. Your attraction will go away and her attraction will come and he will attack this parrot. Then you can call your Sakhi. They tried hard, so many, but they requested, but Krishna refused and does not wanted to return this. They went to Yashoda Maiya, Mother Yashoda, and told, Mother Yashoda, we are very worried, my Sakhi is so worried for this parrot and Krishna has taken and he is not returning. Oh, you should sit here, I am going and I will take this. She at once went where Madhumangal and Krishna was playing with that parrot. Again, again. They told that, can you tell Radhe, Radhe? He at once, and very sweet, like Krishna, in Krishna tune, he began to speak, Radhe, Radhe, Jai Jai Sri Radhe. Oh, they were playing so much. In the meantime, Maa Yashoda came, and he cast one hands of Krishna. Very wicked boy, naughty boy, always playing with birds, animals, here and there, doing this and that. Oh, and took that bird. I will give a slap to you. And Krishna, what to do, he could not. And he took that bird and went away. And he did, she gave it to Lalita and Vishakhan, they took that bird. Krishna was so much worried. But he was helpless in front of Yashoda Maiya. she rebuked him so much. Being the Supreme Personality of Godhead, any fear cannot come to Krishna. By the name of Krishna, all kinds of fear, all kinds of distress and sorrow and everything may go. But yet this Krishna is helpless in front of her mother or any gopi. Any gopi can cheat Krishna. They are so qualified. So, this parrot was very dear to Srimati Radhika. This parrot was of Srimati Radhika. So Sriya Shukha, Ubacha told, if that Sukh is of Srimati Radhika, then we see how he became Nirvisheshvadi, Brahmavadi, personalist,
impersonalist.
How he became? Why he went forest, leaving his father devotee, work, very good devotee? Why he was not meditating Krishna, worshipping Krishna, chanting and remembering Krishna? Why he was doing so? Or it is like it. He was playing the role of any devotee. Because if he has not played the role of this, like this, Srimad Bhagavat could not have come. So he has played a role of Nirvisheshvadi, impersonalist. He came in contact of Vyas, and now he became Rasik by learning Srimad Bhagavatam. But he was so much Rasik in his before pastime. He was very near and dear to Krishna and Radhika. When Krishna was going to disappear with Radhika and all Brajavasi, he told Sukh that you'll have to be in this world. Because after us, you'll have to preach Krishna Bhakti here and you'll have to bring Srimad Bhagavatam in this world. So you'll have to be. He was so worried and he told that I cannot live without you pairs, conjugal. I want to go the same place where you are and I want to serve. But Krishna told that, no, you will have to be some time here, because if you will go, world will be ruined, there will be no bhakti. So you will have to preach bhakti in this world and you will have to leave. So he was here. Krishna went, all gopis went, Lila was disappeared, so Sukh was moving here and there. At last he cannot live without any Sangha of Bhakta, association of any good Rasik Bhakta. He was searching a place where he can hear the glories of Krishna and pastimes of Krishna. He at once flew to Kailash, where Shankar was telling Harikatha to
Parvati
Devi. The same subject of Srimad Bhagavatam. So, sat on the branch of any tree, and he was also hearing. In the meantime, when Shankar began the Srimad Bhagavatam, Parvati slept. Like so many, when I will tell very good Siddhants, not this story, then some of you will
yawn,
and after that
try to sleep,
and fell down. So don't do like this. She slept, but that parrot began to do again, what, whom, yes, go on, like this. In the tune of, he was very expert to take any tune. He took the tune of Radhika, he took the tune of Krishna, and here he was taking the tune of Parvati. So Shankar could not understand, and he was going telling. When Srimad Bhagavat was to be end, then she woke and told, I have not heard. I was slept. Oh, you slept? But who was telling like that? Go on. Then he began to see who is hearing. If anyone unqualified to hear, I will cut his head by my three
trigon.
So he was looking here and there. He saw that on the branch of a very dense tree, very green, and that parrot was sitting and he was doing. At once he took his trigons and followed to kill her. He flew from there and came in the cottage of Vyasdev very nearby. He was following. He came to Vyas and asked, have you seen any parrot coming here? He told that, my friend, why you are searching that parrot? To kill him. Why? He was not qualified to hear Srimad Bhagavatam, but he has heard. Can you tell what is the result of hearing Srimad Bhagavatam? Yes.
Immortal.
He will be immortal. Never die. And he will have the nectar of all Srimad Bhagavatam. He will go to Braja if he has purely heard this. And he will be immortal. Anyone cannot kill him. Oh, knowing this fact that he has heard and he has become immortal, he will not be killed, and you are pursuing him like mad person? Then he smiled, and Shankar also smiled, and he returned back. He directly went in the mouth of his best wife,
Vitika.
And there he was for 16 years in the home of Vyasdev's wife. Vyasdev began to tell all katha, and he was happily living here. After 16 years, Vyas told, who are you here? Living in my wife's home? Very, very patiently and very pleasantly. Come on. You should not give dukkha.
Any trouble to your
trouble
mother?
You should not make any problem for your mother. Come on. He told, I will not come. Why? I don't come in this Maya world. Maya, you know? Attachment. Not attachment to Krishna, but attachment to worldly persons, worldly wife, worldly children, worldly these things. This is world, Maya. Maya means there are two letters, Maya. To whom you are thinking that she is my wife, he is my husband, he is my children, he is, this house is mine, this body is myself, all this is Maya. Ma, no. Ya, what you are seeing, all is Maya. So I will not come in Maya. He told that I can remove Maya, I have power to remove. You should come. He told that I don't believe on you. To whom you believe? I believe in Krishna. If Krishna can come and tell that I have belief. Then he told. He prayed to Krishna at once. Krishna heard his prayer and he at once
appeared
there and told, oh, so you should come out of your mother's womb. He told that, who are you? I am myself, Krishna. Oh, Krishna. He became happy. He told us, I don't want to come in Maya. Because you are not here. We have left, your pastimes have left this world. And everywhere is Maya. So I don't want to come in Maya. He told that, for a moment, I am taking my Maya. So you should come. At once Krishna took his Maya from this world and Sukadeva Goswami came from the womb. And he at once ran away. Krishna disappeared and Vyasa was following him. So Sukadeva Goswami is really the parrot of Srimati Radhika. Otherwise he cannot tell a Srimad Bhagavat like this. It appeared, Srimad Bhagavatam, Krishna appeared in a shape of Bhagavatam in the heart of Vyasadeva, you know. And he, Vyasadeva taught to Sukadeva Goswami. But it became more and more sweet from the mouth of Sukadeva Goswami. Because in Srimad Bhagavatam it has been told, in third shloka of Srimad Bhagavat, first canto. Nigama kalpataror galitanga phalam sumukhad amrita drava sanjutam pivata bhagavatam rasamalayam rasamayo rasika bhum bhavuta. This fruit, it has no
skin.
Skin. And peel.
And not
seed.
No guthali.
No seed, no string.
Nothing. To fell. All is a rasa and a rasa. Out, in, here, there, always rush. Everywhere, full of rush. Not full of rush. Itself full of rush. Full of rush means that there is a pot. And eat that, in doubt that there is some rasa. Not like this. Srimad Bhagavat is itself a rasa. Incarnation of Krishna. Krishna is ocean of rasa. So this book is also ocean of rasa itself. It is in Golok Vrindavan. From there, who brought it? Sukadeva Goswami, in his mouth. Mango, very sweet. But if a parrot has touched it, then it becomes so, so sweet. So Srimad Bhagavata itself says sweet, but the tone, the sound, the heart of Sukadeva Goswami is so sweet that this fruit, Srimad Bhagavata, became more and more sweet. Nigam kalpato rugalitam phalam Here, what is Nigam? What is Kalpataru? How it came? So he is telling. Ekirtan should be done. To take rest and then I will tell. Jaya ki jaya. Radha Ramani Hari Govind. Radha Ramani.
Radha Kriba Kataksha.
Radha Raman जय कुंज बिहारी me again. We are telling this sloka, second sloka, Nigama Kalpataru Galitam. Actually this fruit without any without any
peel
or any koi mane kharab cheez
Skin, seeds, or
anything. Only rush and rush. It was in Vrindavan. Sukhdev Goswami, Brahma first took it from Brahma, Narad, from Narad, Vyasdev, and from Vyasdev took this parrot and he brought it to this world. And this fruit became, this rush became more sweet and sweet by the mouth of. Any mango so sweet, but if it is touched by the mouth of any parrot, it becomes so sweet. Why? Because parrot can smell sweet thing. So he cannot take any sour or any bad thing. He must take very sweetest mango. So sweetest Srimad Bhagavat, he took Sukhdev Goswami, very rasik, of Sukh of Srimati Radhika himself. So he is telling, Pivat Bhagavatam Rasamalayam Muhuraho Rasika Bhuvai. If it is Srimad Bhagavat coming by the mouths of Rasik Vaishnava in the line of disciplic line from Brahma, Narad, Vyas, Sukhdev, and up to now, those who are very qualified in this Srimad Bhagavat by hearing from their Guru. But Guru should be in that line. Otherwise we should not hear. It will be like poison. If serpent touch any mango, it will be poison. Like Srimad Bhagavat is rasa, very sweet. But if any qualified person in the line of Sukhdev Goswami or Narad Vyas and all disciples, acharya, then we should hear. Otherwise, not for business, not to gain money, not to gain praise and worldly things. We should not hear it for making any gain worldly. If you want salvation, it can give. Because it is Kalpataru. Kalpatin means what you wish, it will give.
Desire tree.
Desire tree. You should hear one story of desire tree. There was a desire tree in a very forest, in a forest. Any king went to hunt, and he was whole day hunting. In evening, he was so much thirsty, and he was so much hungry. See, he forget his way how to come out of this forest. He went in dense forest. He saw that, evening is coming, night is coming. And now the wild beasts like tigers and lions and bears, they began to roar. And he was so fearful. How to save from this? Very great problem came. He went on and he became a very beautiful forest. There was a very good pond of good water and a shade of a tree, very good shade. He thought that I should take rest here. So he took water and he sat, and he was so tired and hungry. He thought that, any food can be here that I can take. At once he saw that a dish of very beautiful, sweet and tasteful preparation came. He took very happily. Water? I need water. At once water came in a very good glass, very sweet water. I'm so tired. So if there is a very beautiful palanka bed here, I could have sleep here. At once a very beautiful cot, palanka bed came, and he lie down there, and at once slept came. And so soundly he slept. Tigers and lions were roaring, so in the midtime he awoke. Oh, it's a very dangerous night and dangerous. Wild beasts are here. Lion should not come. Oh, if lion come, then what will we do? At once a lion came. And if he will take me and swallow me, at once he jumped up and swallowed him. This is a desire tree. Huh? Don't you should need this desire tree. But Srimad Bhagavat is not like a desire tree, like this. He will give you such beautiful fruit. What? Krishna Prem he will give. If you like Braj Prem, he will give. If you want to serve Dwarka, Queens, Satyabhama and all, he can give. If you want to serve Ram, he will give. So in this sense he is desire tree. So we should try to serve this Srimad Bhagavatam here. Up to what time? When we are in this world. After this world also. Pivat Bhagavatam Rasam Alayam Muhur Muhur Rasika Bhuv Bhavka. Oh, Rasik and Bhav. You should hear this. Until you become, you don't become Murcha.
Faint.
Again, again, you should hear. So how it is? This book is Srimad Bhagavatam Rasamayalayam, Ocean of Rasa. How? Because in first shloka, Janamadasya Jata Anvayaditaratasya. Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur has explained this shloka for more than 1 month. Only this shloka, in various ways, as our Sanatana Goswami, Jiva Goswami, Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur has explained in so many ways. There are about more than 300 Bhashyakar
commentators
of Srimad Bhagavatam. But among them, only having the teaching of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in his line, Sanatana Goswami and Jiva Goswami and Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur, especially Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur, his explanation is supermost, very easy and very, very
attractive,
charming, very sweet. So our sampradaya, we Gaudiya Vaishnava, especially in the line of Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Bhakti Vinod, all we like Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur. But he is telling, I am explaining only the remnants of left by Srila Sanatana Goswami and Jiva Goswami. Understand? His explanation is not other than Srila Sanatana Goswami and Jiva Goswami. Only he is taking remnant and making it more beautiful, maha, maha, maha prasad. Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur here and Jiva Goswami is telling, Janamadasya Jataha. From whom all world has been created. And supported by him. And at last all worlds mix in him. He is supermost, supreme personality of Godhead, he is Krishna, Satyam Parama Dhimahi. He is Satya. Satya means?
Truth.
Eternal truth. Parama. Parama Satya.
Supreme
truth. He lives where? In Golok Vrindavan. So satyam parma dhimahi, I meditate that person. This is first explanation. And brief, very brief I am giving. Second, this world has come from Krishna. Janma dasya jatah. Janma of Adi Rasa. Adi Rasa means?
Original.
Adi means yes, Shingar. Shingar must mean Madhur Ras. Madhur Ras is called Shingar Ras and also Adi Ras. Adi Ras. So Adi Ras has come from whom? From Krishna, because he is ocean of Ras. Satyam Parma Dhimahi. I meditate that Satyam Parma Dhimahi. Third, a Ras cannot come from alone Krishna. If Krishna is alone, he is Nirvishesh Tattva. So must be Srimati Radhika and all gopis. So conjugal here, from conjugal, both Radha and Krishna mixing becomes a Ras. In two ways. Madhuras comes from Radha and Krishna. So, Janma Dasya Jataha Anvayadi Taratasya Anvay and Itar. Anvay and Vyatire. Anvay means?
Meeting.
In Anukullena.
Direct.
And Itar means?
Unfavorable.
No. Vyatirek.
Opposite.
Indirect. Direct and indirect. No? What is direct and indirect? Always speak truth. This is direct. What is indirect? Don't speak.
Don't tell lie.
Don't tell lie. One thing. Nothing separate thing. One thing. But it depends on the telling of mood of telling. Don't tell lie, always speak truth. Both are same, but one has been told direct and another
indirect.
Here, Ras comes from Krishna and Radhika, direct and indirect. Here the meaning will be that when meeting, then conjugal Ras comes as a meeting. And when they are separated, when Krishna goes to cowherd or he goes to Mathura and Vrindavan, then it becomes what Ras?
Viparambha
Ras. So, when there are two Ras, meeting and
separation,
then it will be full, otherwise half. If there is no separation mood, Krishna cannot be more happy in meeting. So it adds that. So Anvayatirek means by meeting and by separation in two modes. Meeting Ras and Milana Ras and
separation
mode both. So the Ras comes in this way. When both are meeting, Ras is going on. Both are singing, all the gopis, Srimati Radhika. At that time, Srimati Radhika and Krishna are conjugal in the middle. And all round gopis. At once Krishna became lakhs and lakhs Krishna. With each gopi he became one Krishna. But it is affluence. So Vrindavan, in Vrindavan affluence should not come. Otherwise it will be affluence as Swarjibhav. So here Krishna did not manifested in lakhs and lakhs Krishna. But there was one Krishna. And he was simply running and dancing in so way that all used to say, oh, Krishna is with me, Krishna with me. Very quickly running and dancing. So no affluence. No? But
The persons don't know fact, they will tell that, oh, Krishna became lakhs and lakhs as gopis were. But actually it was not so. Srimati Radhika was saying that he is with me. But when he used to see to another gopi, oh, very fastly he is running and quickly going to that gopi, and he is doing like this and this. Sometimes Krishna is singing. And after that, the same tune, same song, Krishna is singing. And after that, gopis are singing, Srimati Radhika is singing. Krishna did it sa re ga ma pa, five, like kokil, like cuckoo birds, very melodious tone. But Srimati Radhika did what? Sa re ga ma pa dha ni sa. Oh Krishna, oh sadhu, 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 sadhu. I cannot do like you, so sweet, so high. And Krishna embraced Radhika, oh sadhu, sadhu. All gopis were seen, all stopped and hearing Srimati Radhika. Krishna told, now you are tired. Where is your anklet? Your anklet is there. He took anklet and he tied in the lotus feet of Srimati Radhika. And he took his
pitambar
and he washed the mouth of Srimati Radhika. This fate, how beautiful. Krishna was controlled by Radhika and gopis here. He wanted to massage the feet of gopis here. So this is meeting rush. At that time, what Srimati Radhika will tell, order, Krishna will carry out. This is meeting rush. And separation mood, vyatirek, what is that? Krishna went to Mathura. All gopis were lamenting and weeping. Uddham came. Krishna told that Uddhav go and pacify them. He went there and he saw all gopis are like dead. Some gopi mane Srimati Radhika, like mad, and she was about to die, very lean and thin, always weeping, lamenting. She saw a bamboo bee, very black. She thought that, oh, this is
messenger
of Krishna. Because he is black, his messenger should be black. He has taken so much wine, madhupuri, you know, where madhu means wine is there, a stock, very big stock. And the shopkeeper is who? Wholesale dealer is Krishna. And his friend. And he has taken wine and he has become mad and he has come to pacify her. Go away from here. Don't touch my. This is separation. So many things to tell. But now time is over. I should not speak more. So I am leaving it for tomorrow. You should come punctually at 5:30. Some are neglecting kirtan. That Maharaj is not here, so why we should go first?
Don't go.
Come first. If you are not waiting for me eagerly, that Maharaj should come and we should be here. When Maharaj will come, then after that we will come, like slowly there. Don't do that. Otherwise I will make late, and I will see that you are not sitting, you are not singing, you are not having Srimad Bhagavatam and everything ready, then I will tell that I am not feeling well.
I am so tired.
I should today I should take rest. So you should not this thing. I see that some persons, they don't avail aarti. At that very time they chant Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. I think this is not better. At the time of kirtan, you should join. At the aarti, you should see aarti. You should join aarti. At the time of chanting name,
be alone or anywhere, chant Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. Where there is going on kirtan, how you can chant? Your mind will be going here, there. So you should do all the times in time. At the time of aarti, we should try to. This is a part of bhakti. No? Archan. When you are in Srimad Bhagavat, patiently being observed, we should hear one letter, one words from ear, we'll take here. Otherwise, we cannot gain anything. If you have at that time any lust, think so many problems, how to marriage, how to do this, that, don't. Srimad Bhagavat is solved itself. So take out all these desires and all these things, and then come here. Like Parikshit Maharaj, otherwise you will not gain. Be first. Parikshit Maharaj giving up his throne, his everything, desires and everything. Empty heart, you should come. Then I will
fill it up
by this amrit. Mane this nectar of Srimad Bhagavatam. Gaur Pramanam. You should now do aarti and kirtan. Any prasad?
No, they want to give some.
They have done?
I have done. Yes.